Logarithms Made Easy, brought to you by Ketzbook. Welcome back. Today we're going to talk about what a log function is because logs are very important in science and there are even some common log scales that everyone should be familiar with, such as the decibel scale, the Richter scale, and the pH scale. I'm going to introduce each of those log scales and we will also learn how to easily calculate base 10 logs. But first, what is a log function? A logarithm is the inverse of an exponential function. Okay, but what does that really mean? Let's look at a few examples. 3 squared equals 9, right? Well, we can rewrite that same equation in terms of logs this way. Log base 3 of 9 equals 2. Notice that the numbers in both of those equations are the same. They're just arranged differently. For the log equation, the 2 and the 9 have switched places. In both expressions, the 3 is the base or the number that is multiplied by itself. The 2 is the exponent or the number of times the base is multiplied by itself, and the 9 is the result of the exponential function. So if a question were to ask you, what is log base 3 of 9? What the question is really asking you is this. 3 to what power equals 9? Let's try a couple of practice problems to really get this. What is the log base 5 of 5? Well, the question is really asking, 5 to what power is 5? And the answer, of course, is 1, because 5 to the power of 1 is 5. How about this? What is log base 10 of 1,000? Pause the video and try to figure it out. Remember that this question is really asking 10 to what power is 1,000. Once you realize that, we know that 10 to the third power is 1,000, so the answer is 3. It turns out that base 10 logs are so common and important that we call base 10 logs the common logarithm. So if a question simply asks you for the log of 100, that is the same as the log base 10 of 100, which is also the same as asking 10 to what power is 100. In addition to that, the log function on your calculator calculates base 10 logs. Some calculators write it in capital letters, while other calculators write it in lowercase letters, but the log button here calculates the common log, that is, the base 10 log of a number. For some numbers, the common logarithm can be easily calculated or estimated. Let's try several examples to help us see the bigger picture. What is the log of 10,000? In general, for base 10 logs, think about what the number is in scientific notation. 10,000 is 10 to the fourth power, and the log of 10 to the fourth is simply the exponent, that is, 4. 1,000 is 10 to the third power, so the log of 1,000 is 3. 100 is 10 to the second power, so the log of 100 is 2. 10 is 10 to the first power, so the log of 10 is 1. 1 is 10 to the zeroth power, so the log of 1 is 0. In fact, the log of 1 is always 0, no matter what the base of the log is. 0.1 is 10 to the negative first, so the log of 0.1 is negative 1. In general, numbers greater than 1 will have positive log values, and numbers less than 1 will have negative log values. 0.01 is 10 to the negative second, so the log of 0.01 is negative 2. 0.001 is 10 to the negative 3, so the log of 0.001 is negative 3. We can start to see a predictable pattern here. The scientific notation exponent tells you the value of the log. In addition, notice how as the logs increase by 1, the number itself is 10 times larger. This is true for any increase or decrease of the log by 1, that the number increases or decreases tenfold. And it is cumulative. For example, if the log increases by 2, the number is 10 to the second, or 100 times larger. But what if we wanted to know the log of something like 4.07 times 10 to the third? How do we solve that? Although we can't solve that mentally, we can estimate that the log will be between 3 and 4 because the number is larger than 10 to the third but smaller than 10 to the fourth. Go ahead and pause the video and try to solve it using your calculator. The correct answer is 3.61, which is in the range of what we estimated. Now let's talk about applications of this and three common log scales. The first log scale that I would like to mention is the Richter scale, which is a log scale for the magnitude of earthquakes. Earthquakes have a very large range of magnitude, and a log scale makes that more manageable. An earthquake typically occurs when tectonic plates on the Earth's crust move, causing the Earth to shake. The energy of that shaking travels through the Earth in seismic waves that can be detected and recorded. The magnitude of the earthquake was originally defined as the logarithm of the maximum amplitude in micrometers. Because the Richter scale is a log scale, an increase in one magnitude has 10 times the amplitude. So an earthquake with a magnitude of 8 has 10 times the amplitude as an earthquake with a magnitude of 7, 100 times the amplitude as an earthquake with a magnitude of 6, and 1,000 times the amplitude as an earthquake with a magnitude of 5. Two other common log scales are the decibel scale and the pH scale. The decibel scale is a log scale of sound intensity or loudness, and the pH scale is a log scale of acidity. The human ear is able to hear a very large range of sound intensities, and our perception of loudness is nearly logarithmic itself. So the bell scale was created to reflect that. 0 bells is barely audible. 2 bells is a quiet whisper. 5 bells is normal conversation, 12 bells is maybe a loud police siren, and 13 bells would be like a gunshot or fireworks, although the loudness of things is highly dependent on how far away they are from you. Because it's a log scale, 13 bells has 10 times the sound intensity as 12 bells, and if you compare 12 bells with 5 bells, 12 bells is 10 to the 12 minus 5 power times as intense. That is 10 to the 7th power, or 10 million times as intense as the sound of 5 bells. Now please pause the video and consider how many times the sound intensity of 5 bells is compared to 2 bells. To figure this out, subtract 2 from 5 and the answer should be 10 to that power. So 5 bells is 10 to the 5 minus 2, or 1,000 times the sound intensity of 2 bells. All this time we've been talking about the bell scale, but what about the decibel scale? Well, that's simple. A decibel is a tenth of a bell, so 13 bells is 130 decibels. 12 bells is 120 decibels, 5 bells is 50 decibels, and 2 bells is 20 decibels. The pH scale is yet another log scale that is near and dear to my heart. It differs a bit from the other two log scales we've already talked about because it is actually a negative log scale. That means that the lower the pH, the more acidic the solution is. So a solution with a pH of 0 would be considered very acidic and quite corrosive. In fact, it is 10 times more acidic than a pH of 1. Similar to the other log scales, a decrease in one pH corresponds to a solution with 10 times the acidity. A pH of 14, on the other hand, has a very low acidity and is considered to be quite basic. Basic solutions are also corrosive. I will discuss why that is in my next video on acids and pH. But first, let's end with one more question. Comparing a pH of negative 1 and a pH of 1, which solution is more acidic and how many times more acidic? Pause the video and try to figure it out. You may be wondering whether a negative pH is even possible, but it most certainly is possible. In fact, concentrated solutions of strong acids often have negative pHs. So the answer to our question is that the pH of negative 1 is more acidic. In fact, it is 100 times more acidic because it is 2 lower on the pH scale and 10 squared is 100. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, or check me out at ketzbook.com. If you have any questions or comments, be sure to share them below and have a wonderful day.